studio, I share tips from practice that help your management team to be future-proof. The world of management and internal organization seems to evolve around the concept of control. The term control measure often pops up in this context. I understand the desire to have as much grip as possible on what will happen in the future. I come across people who appear to have this idea that if you plan smartly, timely identify important risks, take appropriate measures and also check their effectiveness, that then the reality will unfold as you envisioned it. This mindset can easily turn out to be an illusion. You will recognize this from your own practice. Think of the COVID-19 pandemic that has happened to all of us. The control illusion is not terribly useful, and fortunately there are ways that are more future-proof. First of all, it helps if you realize as a team that there are quite a few actors and factors that can directly or indirectly impact on what you value. And the majority are out of your control. One of the meanings of the verb to control is to have a grip on, to be able to influence something. Consider the expression having a controlling interest in a company. This concerns a majority interest of the accompanying influence and power. Controlling can also mean that you are good at something, such as mastering a subject, a language, or your emotions. It can also mean holding back, restraining oneself, self-control. Yet another and widespread meaning is to curb, to check, or to inspect someone or something. And then there is a completely different meaning, taking care of, protecting. All these very different meanings correspond with different management styles. They will also evoke very different reactions by those exposed to these management styles. It makes a big difference whether it's all about restraining versus caring. Everyone loves to be taken care of. Always remember that this is what makes your internal and external clients happy. I trust your team will benefit from these tips, and more will come.